Story, a statewide day of action. That is what United Wisconsin is calling it as they ramp up their effort to try and recall Governor Scott Walker. They are hoping this weekend will put them over the top when it comes to recall signatures. Our Brandon Cruz shows us how some are now going door to door.
Careful, it's a little icy.
Despite the cold weather,
I'm all bundled up.
Jennifer Halsey is knocking on every door she can in the River West neighborhood on Saturday, part of a statewide day of action, asking people to sign recall petitions.
Would you be interested in signing today?
Yeah, I'll sign.
For Governor Scott Walker and Lieutenant Governor Rebecca Clayfish.
Today has been a very interesting experience. It's been very exhilarating. There's a lot of people who we've talked to who have already signed petitions. And so we're glad to be out here knocking on doors.
They're getting free media. I think this is a marketing ploy.
Rick Boss, the vice chair of the Milwaukee Republican Party, sees Saturday's activities as more of a gimmick.
If they're going door to door, maybe the signatures they say they have, they don't in fact have.
On Thursday, Mike Tate of the Wisconsin Democratic Party said that more than 500,000 signatures had already been collected. And for Halsey, going door to door can help those wanting to sign a recall petition.
There's some folks who can't, unfortunately, you know, are unable to get out of their home.
Because I haven't been able to do anything.
Sure, sure.
So I adore it that you're working for me.
I know they're going door to door. So again, I think it's more marketing. It also could be a sign of desperation.
And while disagreeing on the issue, both Boss and Halsey agree that the effort to get enough signatures to force a recall will be a success.
It's great to hear that so many people have already gone ahead and signed and, you know, have voiced their support for the recall effort.
And the goal by United Wisconsin is 720,000 signatures, which they think would ensure a recall election. Boss says that his party is ready to run on the governor's record and says that he hopes that the governor's opponent is one of the Democratic senators who left the state in March. Live, you know, it's one of those things, too, where they sit there and he's like, you know, bring anybody on, but one of those guys will separate the two candidates completely.
Absolutely. Each side has their own spin. It is interesting, though, that they, because they really have a lot more time. I think January 17th was the deadline. They're just trying to do it early.
That and get as many as possible. That way they can get rid of any of the bogus signatures or signatures that don't meet the requirements to be able to sign that effectively.
Just trying to make sure they have time, I guess.
Yes.
All right. Thanks, Brandon. Well, is this a sign?